the world is injected. Devil is ejected. Whatever that is born of God overcoming the world, and this is the victory that overcoming the world, even our faith. The faith in the word and the faith in the name will set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. I don't care what they've implanted into your system. As I speak right now, Jehovah restores your dignity in the name of Jesus Christ. Before the end of this week, you will experience 3 times multiplication. Every oppression of the devil inside you, I decree an end in the name of Jesus Christ.
Unlocking the Supernatural, Part 3a. Unlocking the Supernatural, Part 3a. I'd like us to know this morning that every believer is a carrier of the supernatural. Every believer is a carrier of the supernatural. Please, before this word goes forth from the Lord, make sure you have generated expectations. If you come here as a routine, I told someone during the week, I said, what you come to see in service is what you get from the service. If you come for healing, when as you are going, you get healed. If you go for something else, what you come to see is what you get. Please be in this service to encounter your God. Let your spirit man be connected. If you check out through scriptures, many were always with Jesus in most cases. But in some cases, only some individuals have a standout testimony. Or quote unquote, a testimony that's outstanding. When many were going with Jesus, Jesus even said, the woman with issue of blood tried to touch, meander her way to touch Jesus. And one of them said, so Jesus said, the virtue is gone out of me. And he said, many are thronging you. Many are jumping at you. But only one had a different testimony. What am I saying? Don't be among those who are thronging. Be the one that is touching. Don't be among those who are in church. Be the one that is in touch. Many were in church with Jesus, quote unquote. Only one woman was in touch with the virtue. So please be sensitive. What you come to do in church, that means what you get from church. And I know, as we redefine your mind right now, in case it's not well defined before, today the Lord will touch you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every believer is a carrier of the supernatural. John 3:6. He that is born of the Spirit is what? A spirit.
He that is born of the flesh is a flesh.
He that is born of the flesh is a flesh.
Born of the flesh is a flesh.
Born of the flesh is a flesh. 2 Corinthians 5:17. He that is in Christ is a new creature. New creature simply means he is no more a human being.
A new creature, born of the Spirit. Born of the Spirit. Born of the Spirit. So every believer,
genuine believer, that God accredits as a believer. Remember, I keep saying this. What you call faith may not be faith to God. I have faith. You have faith, nothing has changed. Then query your faith. Because the Bible says, without by faith, all things are possible. And now your faith is not changing anything. Which means your faith is not accredited by God as faith.
So, I mean, believe. Now,
during the week, I got a message from Czech Republic in Europe. 2 ladies from different places. One sent me a message and said that I think somebody in Czech, another person, told the lady that meet my pastor, blah, 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 blah. So, the lady called me, the first white lady called me and said that, please. They said one of our friends in another town in Czech is demonized. But to cut a long story short, that demonized lady herself called, said, I'm occultic. And got so good, some 2-3 people were in my office, some 2-3 guys were in my office. Now, as I was communicating with this lady, the one in Czech, when she sent me that she's occultic, that she's a satanist, that she wants to be free, as I was praying, I'm talking to her, suddenly, sir, her voice changed. No, he said, you are lost. I said, me, I'm lost. Who is lost between me and you? Because what we're saying just changed. Power past power. As we're talking, he said, no, no. Ah. I told the people beside me, I said, what's going on? It's not the same girl I was talking to, and I said, no, not what? Then I connected the spirit. I said, okay, I've understood. I said, pray for her on WhatsApp. You know, I mean, what audio call. And suddenly, say, okay, no, I will go. Ah, who are you? Then at the point, he said, don't kill me. All the way from Czech Republic. If you are born of the spirit, you carry the supernatural power of God. You see, the Bible says the word I speak unto you, they're not an enticing of men's wisdom, but demonstration. If you cannot demonstrate what you carry, you are inferior. You are not genuine. Every believer is a carrier. Not because I'm a pastor, sir. It is because of the understanding of what you carry inside you. You cannot have it, and it will not show by itself. Christianity is not theoretical. Christianity is practical. Christianity is not doctrinal. Christianity is practical, not the doctrine. Doctrine is fine, but Christianity is beyond doctrine. It is a lifestyle. Glory to God. And that's why the knowledge of the truth is key to assessing our redemptive rights in Christ. That is, the knowledge of what makes you a supernatural person is what helps us to access our redemptive rights in Christ, including having the keys to operating supernatural. We must know what are the keys. Matthew 16:19, he said, I give unto you keys of the kingdom. So there are keys in the kingdom that guarantees our access to supernatural. Hallelujah. I give unto you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth. Hear this. This revelation is really helping. Whatever you shall bind on earth, I can be in South Africa and be binding in China. I can be in South Africa and be binding in Australia. Bind on earth. That's why the lady in Czech was being bound by power. Why? Anywhere you're on earth, you're in charge. Glory to God. This morning, we'll be looking at the key of the name of Jesus. The key of the name of Jesus. Please, as the service is going on, have an high expectation of divine visitation. As the word is going forth, remember the Holy Ghost has gone into the atmosphere. And when the Holy Ghost moved into the atmosphere, suddenly creation became a reality. Everything was being created. Bah, 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 bah. Just like that. Why? The Holy Ghost moved into action. So the Holy Ghost is already at work. If you allow the Holy Ghost, whatever you came in with as a challenge shall return as a testimony. Amen. Let me hear you say a big amen. Amen. The name of Jesus is pregnant with wonders. The name of Jesus is pregnant with wonders. The reason why you see a woman that is pregnant with a big stomach is because there's something inside. The name of Jesus is as big as you understand it. The name of Jesus is as big as understanding is. That's why somebody who has been praying over an issue for 10 years, nothing happened. And somebody now pray for the person, in 1 minute, something happened. Same name of Jesus. Same name of Jesus, not different. The Jesus that prayed through the person is the same Jesus that this person prayed, but their understanding is different. So the name of Jesus is as big as my understanding, is as big as your understanding. Because understanding is power. Isaiah 9:6, the Bible says that unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and his name shall be called Wonderful. That's verse 6. Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, Wonderful. So the name of Jesus is pregnant with wonders. And in this service, you will see the wonders of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, if you look at it, Acts chapter 3, verse 2. And a certain man, lame, from his mother's womb was carried, was being laid down. From what his mother, let's read together. And a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask of alms that enter into the temple. Hear this. When I was watching the testimony of our dear brother last week, that said he's been deaf, partially deaf, for 35 years. He said, I thought it's normal. There are some situations that have been normalized in our lives. Poverty has been normal. This man, begging of alms, he was born crippled. Hence, he saw being crippled as normal. Whatever you have been going through over the years, that is normal. Which is abnormal. Today, it shall be over. Amen. Today, it shall be over. Amen. Devil can make you think poverty is normal. Devil can make you think, not seeing properly is normal. Devil can make you think that menstrual pain is normal, is abnormal, sir. Menstrual pain is not normal in the realm of the spirit. For we have been redeemed from the curse of the law. We have been redeemed from the curse. We have been redeemed, not that we shall be redeemed. We have been redeemed. It's a curse. And by redemption, you have been redeemed. Some people, when they say their menstrual period is coming, they start praying. They start fasting. For what? What Christ has paid. When I mean, fasting for what? In the sense that maximize it. Christ has paid the price. In that context, in that understanding. Now, I don't care how long you've been that challenge. Right now, that ache, that pain, that lump disappears in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Whatever is in your body that is have been there for more than 1 week, whatever has been your body that is negative, hear me and hear me well if you believe, whatever has been your body that is abnormal beyond a week, I decree right now, it disappears in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Whatever my heavenly Father has not planted, the Bible says, shall be uprooted. I decree, whatever has not been planted by God is uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. So no matter how long you have been in that challenge, you are coming out today. Acts chapter 3 and verse 6. Then Peter says, "Silver and gold I have none, but such as I have, I give thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. He said immediately. Not later. Immediately. I'm so sure. Few of us here witnessed the testimony of that woman that was brought from Nigeria on a wheelchair in 2016. Do you remember? They wheeled her on this. You see, God is so humorous. God made it in that service. I said, "You need healing, come out, I want to touch you." Mysteriously. And by the time they wheel up from here, my body cringed. Hi, how can I be here and somebody be on a wheelchair? I'm telling you, it hurts me. And after second service, went outside there, by that corner. I said, "Mama, do you believe you can walk?" He said, "Yes." "Do you believe you can walk?" He said, "Yes." "You're going to walk right now." I said, "In the name," the video is still here. It's available. "In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Rise up and walk. Rise up and walk." Without pulling her up. Maybe Peter pulled this one up. I didn't pull. Without putting her, I said, "Rise up." She took a step. Took a step. Before the eyes of the old church, where she was wheeled, she walked. Remember? She danced here during church service. The name is as powerful as your understanding. The name is she was flown from Nigeria to South Africa. She walked on by herself. On the spot. Not later, sir. On the spot, God wanted to shamify the devil. That's why he allowed her to be wheeled here. The same place she was wheeled, she danced. She was dancing it. I'd like you to know that an end has come to every oppression in your life. In this service, you are going with your testimonies. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please,
I beg of you, believe. Please believe. Why is the name doing wonders? Because the name of Jesus is self-anointed. The name of Jesus is self-anointed. That name came with an anointing.
Song of Solomon chapter 1 verse 3.
Because of the savour of thy good ointment, thy name is as ointment poured forth, therefore do the virgins love thee.
The name is like a perfume. In most cases, when you take a perfume, even though it's sealed, you still smell it.
You still perceive it. Even though it's sealed, there are some that are very, very powerful that even from outside the box, you still perceive it.
The name of Jesus itself is as ointment poured forth.
And that's what the Bible now says in Mark 16, 17.
And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. In my name. That name
is self-anointed.
It carries anointing. That's why even though you're a new believer, you say, Jesus, something happens. Even though you're an unbeliever, at times, mercy prevails. You call the name, it answers. The name is self-anointed.
Acts 2, 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. There is no limit. Whosoever. You see someone that is not a Christian and is going through a challenge and he is dying. Say, Jesus, deliver me. He will deliver him.
Even though,
because at that moment, he has exhibited a level of faith in Jesus.
At that moment,
he has trusted him.
Even though he's not a Christian,
maybe he's whatever other religion, but say, Jesus will show up.
He will show up because that name carries anointing that delivers anytime, anywhere, the way you want it.
That's why nobody leaves this service today without a tangible sign and wonder in their lives.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Quickly, what are the wonders in the name of Jesus? Number one, it is our direct access to salvation. It is our direct access to salvation.
Romans 10:9-10. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him up from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
It is our direct access. That's why I said, whoever.
Even though he just, committed one demonic act now,
Jesus, have mercy on me. He will save me.
That is how powerful that name is. Direct access. You need not go through anybody to be saved. You don't need any pastor to be saved. You don't need any prophet to be saved.
As long as you confess him in the corner of your room, he will save you.
Direct access to salvation. In the name.
Colossians 1:13. Who had delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear son,
in whom we have redemption through his blood.
So today, everyone shall be delivered from every addiction. Yeah. Whatever you are doing, you don't like doing, by this service, by the power in the name, by the power in the anointing, you shall be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Also, what are the wonders in the name? Number two,
his name is a way maker.
John 14 verse 6, he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life.
I'm the way.
In the name,
there is a way.
Every time you declare the name, a way shows up. Every time you say, Jesus,
there's a way out.
You cannot carry Jesus and be confused. You cannot carry Jesus and be stranded.
He's the way maker. Say he's the way maker. This week he will make a way for you.
This week he will make a way for you. This week he will make a way for you.
Guess what? The Israelites were confronted with the Red Sea. And the Red Sea was the route to their Canaan.
I don't know what race you are facing right now. That looks like a mountain.
I don't know the race you are facing right now.
Maybe there's a big contract coming your way, but there's a race on the way.
Maybe there's a miracle job coming your way,
there's a race on the way.
Maybe there's a marital breakthrough coming your way, but there's somebody in the family of your in-law that's saying you must not marry. This week, I decree in the name that supersedes every other name, there shall be a way in the name of Jesus Christ. There shall be a breakthrough in the name of Jesus Christ.
Also, the wonders in the name include peace in the midst of storm. Peace in the midst of storm. In the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 37 to 41, the Bible says there was a storm and the wind was boisterous. And it is in fact not just a storm, a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship so that it was now full. Verse 38. And Jesus was in the pillow, was sleeping in the VIP. Now look at it, and he was in the inner part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they went to awake him. He was, he was the VIP in that part, the special part, at rest.
Now, as they called
the name answered.
Say, peace be still.
And the storm became calm. I decree by the authority in that name,
every storm in your life, peace be still in the name of Jesus Christ. Peace be still in the name of Jesus Christ. Peace be still in the name of Jesus Christ. Peace be still in the name of Jesus Christ.
What more?
The name
turns death to life.
No matter what is dead in your body right now,
please believe this statement. No matter what is dead, your cells, your tissues, your organs, your system, any part of your body that is dead right now, I decree life is restored in the name of Jesus Christ.
Luke chapter 7, verse 49. While he yet spake,
there came one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, saying to him, thy daughter is dead. Now, just look at it. Thy daughter is dead. Your business is dead. Your career is dead. Your finance is dead. Your children are dead. No matter what it is, the doctor is saying right now. No matter what it is that they've told you right now, hear the good news.
Trouble not the master. Trouble not the answer.
That is devil's advice. There is no way out. It's gone. You see, that business can never be resuscitated. Your career, you only went to school, you are finished.
That's what the doctor is telling you.
Or the devil is telling you.
Now, but when
Jesus had it, that name is the way out.
When Jesus had it, he answered.
That is Luke chapter 9, 7, verse 50 now. Saying, fear not. Tell them about fear not.
Tell them about fear not. Saying, believe only,
she shall be made whole. Your business shall be made whole. Yeah. Your life shall be made whole. Yeah. Your career shall be made whole. Yeah. Whatever is dead in your body around you is back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. Luke chapter 7, then verse 51 now. And when he came to the house, he suffered no man to go in, save Peter, James, and John, and the father and the mother of the maiden. And all wept and bewailed her, for he said, weep not, she's not dead, but sleepeth. Your business is not dead. Your career is not dead. Yeah. Nothing is dead around you. Yeah.
It's only quiet, but in the next few seconds, it's coming back to life. Jesus said, he sleepeth. He sleepeth. The same thing he said to his disciples when he was told that Lazarus was dead. He said, no, let's go and wake up around that sleepeth.
Jesus will always call dead sleep because nothing dies in his hand.
Nothing dies around him.
Jesus is here this morning. Every dead circumstance in your life and around you, by the authority in the name,
I decree, comes back to life now in the name of Jesus Christ. Comes back to life now in the name of Jesus.
Say, I believe. Because that's the only condition. It's the only belief. Say, believe only. Believe only. And now, when they heard that Jesus Christ said he sleepeth, they laughed him to scorn. Verse 53.
knowing that she was dead. And he put them all out.
Get back to your office tomorrow and put everyone that is mocking you out. Despise them. Put them aside. Everyone despising the name you carry, put them out. Don't give them attention.
He put them all out.
That's Jesus. And he put them all out and took her by the hand and called, saying, "Maid, arise. Arise. No deliverance. Arise." Because what you call it is what it is. You don't tell a dead person, arise. You can only tell someone sleeping, wake up.
In the same way, whatever looks dead in your body right now, your organs, your system, your heart, your lungs, your womb, your body, your business, your career, your family, I decree, arise in the name of Jesus. 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 Arise in the name of Jesus.
But hear this. To unlock the supernatural by the name. If you must unlock the supernatural by the name, you must, number one, know and understand the mystery behind the name.
Know
and understand. Don't just know it. Understand. Know and understand the mystery. There's a mystery behind the name.
There is a mystery behind the name.
Mark 4:11. Unto us is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom. But on them that are without, these things are like parables. Are like parables.
The lady
in check that I pray for on phone, that was manifesting on phone, a woman, white woman. I don't know her, but I know what I'm saying.
What I said,
God help me to understand.
And by that understanding,
the demon in a white woman in Europe was being subdued.
I've never been to check,
but you see, power can enter anywhere.
No, and they that do know their God and understand it, they will generate exploits. So when you say the name,
don't just say like you are passing the name of your friend.
Number two, declare the name in faith. Declare.
Remember, we're talking about to unlock supernatural by the name.
Declare it in faith. In faith. In book of Acts 3, verse 16.
Acts 3:16. The Bible says that Peter said, Acts 3:16, and his name, through faith in his name, had this man made strong, whom ye see and know. Yea, the man, the
faith
which is by him has given him. So in faith,
the faith
in the man and the faith in Peter.
Faith in the name. Faith in the name.
Put your hand anywhere you want healing right now. Faith in the name will make you whole. Faith in the name will make you whole. Close your eyes right now. Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Faith in the name.
Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Faith in the name. Makes you whole in the name of Jesus. Faith in the name makes you whole in the name of Jesus. Faith in the name makes you whole in the name of Jesus. Faith in the name makes you whole in the name of Jesus Christ.
Drop your hands. Watch it. It's done. I don't care how long it has been. It is done. I don't care how long it has been. It is done.
Say it is done. Say I'm free. Say it is done.
Hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. What more?
It's not enough to declare in the name by faith,
but declare the name boldly. In the name of Jesus. In the name of, devil say yes. In the name of Jesus. Okay. Why? Because it has no effect.
Boldly. Boldly. Like someone
who has the right to say it.
Acts 14 verse 3.
The Bible says that. Acts 14 verse 3. The Bible says that long time therefore abode they speaking boldly in the Lord,
which gave testimony unto the word of his grace and granted signs and wonders to be done by their hands. When we declare the name of the Lord boldly, it births signs and wonders. Boldly. body.
Don't say, what of if it does not happen? Tell yourself, what of if it happens?
What of if nothing happens?
That is my mentality. Anyone dead that God has ever privileged me to pray for that came back to life, that's my understanding. If I pray, it didn't come back, it was my own. I've done my own part. Sincerely speaking. But in most cases, in many cases, they come back to life.
Simply because I just trust God. I just believe God. Boldly, because it is when we say it boldly, it will manifest himself publicly. When you say boldly, because when you say boldly, it shows that you don't care what happens. You know something will happen. Glory to God.
Declare the name boldly. It will answer on the spot. In the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, in this service is a special anointing service. And God has done set of miracles, second set of miracles. And in this third set of miracles, by the anointing, there will be strange effect of God's power. But what is in the anointing oil? 1 Samuel 6, verse 13. The Bible says that when God told Samuel to go to the house of Jesse to locate, you know, a king. When Samuel was to anoint David, the Bible says David took the vial of oil, a horn of oil, 1 Samuel 16, verse 13. And as he was pouring the oil, what we saw was the Spirit of God. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon him, upon David, from that day forward. When the oil was poured, it was the Spirit of God that was being seen. Which means inside the oil is the Holy Ghost. So therefore, the oil in your hand is not oil. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. And it will deliver instant testimonies today.
Amen.
It will deliver instant testimonies today. It will deliver instant testimony today.
Amen.
So, what is in that oil? Number one, the Spirit of the Lord. Say the Spirit of the Lord. I will make sure God helps us to repeat this statement in second and third services. The Spirit of the Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord is the power behind the creation.
Therefore, anything the devil has stolen in your dream,
anything the enemy has stolen
due to your ignorance,
anything the devil has taken
because of your sin or my sin, right now,
the Spirit of God is recreated in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I decree creative miracles in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I decree creative miracles in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I decree creative miracles in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I decree creative miracles in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Spirit moved
on the surface of the surface of the water.
And God said,
the Holy Ghost has moved earlier on and is still moving. And God is speaking through me right now. Therefore, whatever has been stolen, whatever has been taken, whatever has been stolen, whatever is not available, whatever doctors say you don't have, whatever doctors say you need, I decree right now.
They are being created in the name of Jesus Christ. Being created in the name of Jesus Christ. So inside the oil
is the Spirit of God.
Inside the Spirit of God is the power of creation. The power to create. The power to recreate.
And recreate. And recreate. After God made Adam, human beings have not stopped being created. Therefore, there is a recreational process. A recreational process. A recreational process. Therefore, in this service, whatever has been stolen from your body, right now, as the Lord lives,
they are being recreated in the name of Jesus Christ.
Remember, as this service is going on, keep checking yourself. If that, our young brother, that uncle that shared a testimony last week, did not check himself. He said, I blocked the right ear to check my left ear. So if you don't check it, you can't confirm it. If you don't confirm it, you may lose it. So as the service is going on, and whatever comes your way or applies to you
is being declared,
quickly check it. The Bible says, whosoever first dive into it. First dive into it. That is, you got it, you hold it. You got it, you hold it, and say, I got it. Immediately you claim you have gotten it, he can't take it again.
Glory to God. God will establish your testimony today.
Yeah.
If you look at it, the movement of the Spirit of God in man is for the advancement of his destiny.
So as the Holy Ghost comes upon you through the oil again, your destiny shall be advanced.
Amen.
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 In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What else? The oil is the yoke destroying power. Yoke destroying power. Yoke destroying power. Isaiah 10:25-27, he says that 27 says, it shall come to pass. He said, yet a little while, and the indignation shall cease. 27 now says, it shall come to pass in that day that your body shall be taken off the shoulder, and the yoke of your neck, and that same yoke shall be destroyed because. Say because. So as long as anointing is coming on you today, every yoke in your life shall be destroyed.
Yeah. Every yoke in your life shall be destroyed.
Yeah.
Every yoke in your life shall be destroyed.
Yeah.
36 years of yoke on the ice, God destroyed on the spot. 36 years. 36 years. So I don't care how long it has been. Some of us have been managing some pains. One day to go. Some of us have even accepted it. That is one of those things. Today, every negativity in your life that has become a norm, today, they are terminated.
Amen. They are terminated.
Amen.
They are terminated.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
So there's a yoke destroying power in the anointing oil. Yoke destroying power. Yoke destroying power. Yoke destroying power. Also, inside the oil, we have the preservation power of God. The preservation power of God. In Psalm 105, from verse 13 to 15. Psalm 105, 13 to 15. It says, but when they were one from one nation to another, from one kingdom to another, he suffered no man to do them wrong. He rebuked him for their sake. He says, yea, touch not my anointed, and do my prophets no harm. Verse 14 and verse 15. He said, touch not my anointed. As you have been anointed today, all through this year and beyond, you are preserved from evil.
Amen.
You are preserved from destruction.
Amen.
You are preserved from attacks.
Amen.
Your destiny is preserved.
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 Amen.
Maybe you're here, you're on a journey to a wrong place.
By this anointing, your feet and your steps shall be redirected.
Amen.
Your journey shall be redirected.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Ezekiel 9:6. There is a mark that is coming upon you today. That as this mark comes on you, he says, slay utterly old and young, both maids and little children and women, but come not near any man upon whom is the mark, and begin at my sanctuary. So as this mark comes on you, death will see you, they will run.
Yeah.
Accident will see you, they will run.
Yeah.
Evil will see you, they will run.
Yeah.
And this mark comes on you as a point of contact to every member of your family.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
yeah,
by this anointing of today, you are free from every captivity.
Yeah.
You are free from every bondage.
Yeah.
You are free from every harassment.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.